as many of us will be disappearing off on holiday this summer, we'll be starting to think about the types of beaches that we're going to come across and whether or not we're going to have a nice sandy beach or a pebble beach. And that has all been determined by the geology of the rock and the wave energy that is in the particular region where you're going to be. So there are two main types of beach. You have a sandy beach and a pebble beach, and a pebble beach is quite often referred to as a shingle beach. Now, believe it or not, sand actually is just broken down rock that has been eroded over many years, millions of years in some cases, to the tiny grains of sand that we know them as today. Now, if you're on holiday and you have a nice sandy beach, that's probably because you're in a location that has a soft rock and low energy waves that are needing to deposit the material. So therefore that's going to develop and they're going to create nice sandy beaches. If you're in an area that has a harder rock type and higher energy waves, then you're more likely to have a pebble beach or a shingle beach. And that is all to do with the rock that is being eroded around the particular beach that you're at. So I'm on a pebble beach right now, and as you can see, there's lots of headlands that are sticking out here, and there's actually lots of cliffs and stuff to the other side as well. So this, having a pebble beach, is exactly what I would expect here, and that's because all of this rock is being eroded by the waves. The waves are then carrying it away with them, and they're depositing on the beach here, and that is exactly, it's going to build up this pebble beach, which is exactly, as I say, what I would expect here. So there are two different types of beaches, sandy beaches and pebble beaches, and it's all going to be determined by the type of rock in that area and the energy of the waves there too.